now you know why you might want to learn Django. And here's a short overview of things that you should already know before watching this course. First of all, Django is a Python framework, so you should be familiar with Python. At the very least, watch the introductory Python course and write some simple programs. Although Django does use some advanced concepts, we're going to stick to the basics, so a general understanding of the core language will be enough to get you started. You should also know how to use pip to install packages. If you don't know these things, please watch my course on Pluralsight called Managing Python Packages and Virtual Environments. You should also know the basics of web development, and that means you should at least know how to write a simple HTML page. It may be helpful if you also know a bit about CSS styling, although you should be able to follow everything even if you don't. We're also going to touch on the HTTP protocol a bit, which is the protocol that enables a browser to ask a server for a web page. But if you don't know about HTTP, don't worry, it's not hard at all, and I'll explain everything you need to know. Finally, it's also important that you know the basics of databases. We will use a database to store our application's data, and we're going to let Django create and modify our database tables. There's no need to write any actual SQL statements, but you should be familiar with the concepts of tables, rows, or what an insert or update means. So, what do you need to have installed on your system to use Django? Both Python and Django are cross-platform, which means you can work along with this course regardless of your operating system, be it Linux, macOS, or Windows. In this course, I will be working with Django 3, which supports Python 3.6, 3.7, or 3.8. So if you're running an older version of Python, be sure to update. Then there's something that I think no developer should do without, and that's an editor with Python support. For this course, I will be using the Community Edition of PyCharm, which is a very full-featured piece of software with a lot of features for Python development. But there are many, many other editors, and you should be able to follow this course if you use another editor. I will tell you when you will need to take different steps than I do.